So welcome to the course on pigeon of machine elements. We are going through some of the numericals on rolling mounted bearing. So now we will take a numerical based on design for cyclic loads and speeds. That means when there will be different kinds of loads are acting for different time period or different speed on a machines like lathe machine, milling machine, like that, where you are doing different kinds of operations. So while doing different kinds of operation, different types of loads and different speeds you are using. So when your bearings are subjected to this kind of loading, then how to design those bearings or how to select the bearings from an analysis catalog, this kind of numerical we will see now. So it is specified the statement like this: a deep groove ball bearing is to be selected. It is subjected to varying cyclic load as listed below. Expected life of the bearing is 13,000 hours. So life in hours is specified to here, that is 13,000 hours life, and assume radial load factor as 0.56. So they have already given the radial load factor, that is x factor here, as 0.56, and the axial load factor, that is y, is 1.2, and you are asked to find the equivalent dynamic radial load acting on the bearing. So you have to find out the PE, total equivalent radial load dynamic on the equivalent dynamic radial load acting on the bearing total. Okay, so the table is like this. Means in the first column there is the fraction of cycle, like 1/6 fraction there is a heavy shock. Okay, and according to that shock analysis, that is 2.5 for this, that is Ka value. Then next is the fraction of cycle 2.2/6. So moderate shock is there during this period, and there is a shock and stress factor 2. While for the remaining fraction of cycle, there is life shock and radial load, axial load are specified, speed is specified, and the shock and stress factor is 1.2. So for each of these cycle, like first cycle, these are the radial load this much and axial load, and this it is rotating with the speed. Similarly for others. So now let us see how we can solve this kind of problem. So we will write the given data first. X factor is given, y factor is given, expected life is given in hours, and you are asked to find out this PE. Okay, so this is the bearing, and it is supporting, suppose, this milling cutter. So there will be forces acting on this in the tangential direction and in the axial direction. So this is nothing but your radial force and the axial force. So our aim is to find out for each fraction of cycle one by one. First we will find out the equivalent radial load acting for this first fraction of cycle, that we will call it as PE1. Then we will calculate for PE2, then we will calculate PE3, and then we will find out the combined PE, equivalent radial load. So we know that the equivalent radial load for the bearing is given by K into in bracket X into V into FR plus Y into FA. So we'll be making use of these different factors: Ka, X factor, Y factor, FR, FA, and rotation factor. So let us start for the first step. So for first fraction of cycle, PE1 will be equal to, I will be writing this equation, and then we'll be putting the values corresponding to Ka1 is 2.5, X is 0.56, the rotation factor is 1, FR1 is 3500. Then Y factor is 1.2, and FA1 is 1300 Newton. So we'll be getting this value as 8800 Newton. Similarly, we'll find out the for first fraction of cycle, what is the life in million revolutions, that is called as N1. So N1 will be given by fraction of cycle multiplied by LH into N into 60 by 10 raised to 6. So this gives me 78 million revolutions. Similarly, we'll find out it for the second fraction of cycle by putting the respective value of the FR2 and FA2. So I will be getting this 5776 Newton. Okay. Similarly, now we can go for the second fraction of life in million revolutions, that is N2. So N2 will be equal to fraction of cycle multiplied by LH into N by 60 into 60 by 10 to 6. So it will be giving me 182 million revolutions by putting the value of LH and N 700 here. So once it is over, we can go for the third fraction of cycle. So in the third fraction of cycle, again I will be using the same equation for calculating the equivalent radial load. So here my radial force is different and the axial force is different. So I will be getting this 2774.4 Newton. And the third fraction of cycle N3, for that I will be using the remaining fraction of cycle, that is 1 minus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 6, remaining is 0.5. So I am writing this 0.5 fraction cycle here, and RPM with which it is rotating is 800. Okay, so I will be getting this 312 million revolutions. So when I make the sum of this N1 plus N2 plus N3, I will be getting the N, that is 572 million revolutions. So let us make use of this all N1, N2, N3 and P1, P2 and P3 to get the equivalent radial load. So I am writing this N1 into P1 bracket raised to A, because it is a ball bearing, so A is equal to 3. Then 182 multiplied by 5776 raised to power 3. Then 312 into 2774.4 bracket raised to 3 divided by N1 plus N2 plus N3 whole bracket raised to power 1 by 3. So I am getting this value of PE equal to 5494.65 Newton. So this is what is the solution of this particular numerical. So thank you. Thank you very much.